our lovely tentacle porn champion. The biggest game changer to Vel'Koz is mobility champions. Akali will wreck him nowadays with just her pool, but will completely annihilate him with her ultimate up. Katarina, who'll delete him before his E even hits the ground by jumping on him, is also very strong. And Zed, if he's smart enough to play around the stopwatch and Zhonya's, can destroy him pretty easily too. Fizz, because of his strong engage, and E, Ziggs, because of his superior range and poke, and also Xerath, for exactly the same reason, make other viable counters too. So basically, either jump on him or keep your distance. Vel'Koz's passive makes it so that his autos don't actually use projectiles. Also, whenever he hits 3 abilities, he'll deal true damage to enemies. His Q will throw an energy bolt that splits into 2 if recast or after traveling the full distance. It also grants 50% mana back on enemy takedown per bolt. His W creates a fissure on the ground that erupts after a brief delay, and he can passively store up to 2 of these and cast them with just a 1.5 second cooldown between. His E hurls an anomaly on the ground that knocks enemies up, and his ultimate passively allows you to refresh the deconstruction true damage passive by hitting enemies with autos or other abilities, and when activated fires a huge laser that adds stacks to the same passive every 0.75 seconds. In lane, you'll be constantly trying to poke you through angles, so be sure to be smart about it and stay near your minions to make it especially hard for him. Vel'Koz nowadays take a huge variety of spells, maybe heal and barrier being the most common. The problem with spells like exhaust and ignite is that he needs to be close to use them. You could take ignite if you have the ability to jump on top of him, but if you're about to play passive, I'd take teleport over anything else. In terms of power spikes, Vel'Koz is a really good early to mid game champion, but will largely depend on your team's capability to jump on him at the right moment. Level 3, after being able to dematerialize you, and 6, whenever he can constantly keep you researched, are very good level power spikes. He'll most likely go for an early Morello to help with his mana issues, and possibly Liandry's, which will increase his ultimate damage because of its slow. Thank you for tuning in, good luck in your match, and remember, he'll most likely panic if you manage to get very close to him. Save up your CC to interrupt his ultimate since he won't move while casting it, and building MR becomes stupid against him because of his true damage, so go for health instead. Ultimately, have fun doing it.